Hey everybody, it's Fortyware. Welcome back to DK64. Last time we took care of Frantic Factory completely. I'm just taking care of Chunky's stuff at this point. There's a bunch of boulders and stuff, so I can help other Kongs get their stuff. So that's a trombone pad right there. Over here, though, is not a trombone pad. That's a triangle pad. So, hopefully we'll have another banana on the way. And sure enough, we do. So that takes care of that. So that's the first thing. Also important to know, do not go into Angry Aztec if you're going to switch out Kongs. The boulder will reappear. You don't want that. Also, I completely forgot about a fairy that is right next to the banana fairy island. So I'll get that probably right after this. Here, as we go over to here. And I don't believe I'm going to get a golden banana this time. I think I'm going to get, actually, a cranky barrel. Ditties. But we're not going to have any way to get to that at this point. That's a little farther ahead. Now, remember those chimp charge camera? Remember those chimp charge gongs I ignored? Now is not the time to ignore them, because now I have the ability in question. If you're wondering, that area right there with the feather thing, pointless. All this is open that, and you can use Chunky, go in there, pick up a boulder, drop it onto a certain pressure plate, and this opens up, and well, it's basically another wrinkly hint. That's the long and short of it, actually. And if memory serves me right, this is going to be another bug bashing bonus stage, but because it's DK Isles and not Junge Japes or Angry Aztec, you're going to have to be good at this stuff. As you can tell from the Batty Barrel Band and the fact that it was a lot faster this time, as opposed to the last time, you know, at Frantic Factory. Yeah. So, yeah. What was that? I think it was like 4 at Angry Aztec when I did that bonus stage. This time it's going to be like 8. Or 10 even.
Welcome to bonus stage.
And they're going to demand you be pretty good at this. It is pretty forgiving, but once you get used to the fact that... Oh, I thought I had there. There we go.
Well done.
And another banana. See, yep. That's everything we can take care of at the Angry Aztec lobby. Now I'll meet you at that island that I was talking about. The island in question is right over here. Once I swim close to it, you'll actually see that there is actually a tree there. And this first... I believe this is designed to be the first fairy that you get. So in that regard, it's supposed to be the easiest fairy in the game to get. I mean, I was fairly close to it, and the fairy didn't even think twice, so. Obviously, it was meant to get pretty quickly. Now, if memory serves me right, there was also a pineapple switch in a cage here that has a banana. So if you notice right now, we've gotten one of these for DK, one of these for Tiny, one of these for Chunky. Diddy has one, but it's impossible for me to get to at this point. Which leaves Lanky's. And it occurred to me like 3 seconds ago where his is. It's where Kilumsy is. Right on the outside of the cage, there is a grave switch, if memory serves me right. As we all know, I have a very impeccable memory. Being the guru uses information, you are granted certain liberties in the guru club. So, for me, let's see if I'm right. Or will I have to turn in my membership card to the guru race? You dare doubt me? That's what you get for doubting me. Down the great and almighty 40 warrior. Yeah. The guru uses information, strikes again. Anyway, now that we're done with that, now I gotta actually take care of some business. Jungle Japes. Then Angry Aztec. Now about 7 minutes in, and normally I'm keeping these parts around 20 minutes, thereabouts. So, depending on how long this takes, it might take me like 15 minutes just to get all the Jungle Japes bananas. Also, let me switch out to Chunky really quick because I want to take care of this thing, but I don't believe this is for him. I believe this is for Lanky, or maybe even Tiny. Yep. So this should be another free banana for Lanky. Which gave me number 62. The DK outs typically do involve you to use multiple Kongs. Some of them will use up to 2 or 3 even. Which makes sense now that you actually have all the Kong's abilities as opposed to when you had, say, DK, when you can only rely on him and Diddy for a little bit. So anyway, time to take care of Chunky's stuff. I believe he's supposed to be the older brother of Kitty Kong from DKC3, you know, the extremely powerful, but... Well, yeah. The extremely powerful, strong, but not too bright Kong. Well, he was a baby. What do you expect? As if the only difference is if Chunky loses, he cries, and if Kay lost, he screamed. That was it. That was the only difference. So, let's see if I remember where Chunky's stuff is. Well, obviously, Cranky's lab is one. Because, well, it always is. But a bunch of his stuff actually is right here. There's 3 golden bananas in this general area for Chunky. Number 1 is right here. Yeah. And Chunky is supposed to be extremely heavy, so X marks the spot for your ass. And down we go. So yep, more free stuff. You can ignore the bats. All they do is just annoy you. And take care not to fall off the edge. Because that's instant death. Which, as we know, guys, does not cause game overs or anything like that since you have infinite lives. I can't believe the game over screen is actually if you quit the game. That is nuts, man. Seriously. No, I seriously think it's really dumb. Anyway, over here... These are really easy to grab, golden banana. And what's on the other side, you ask? Oh, a cursed plat. You can't, like, I haven't done it before, but you can just default jump on enemies and it will knock them down. Whoops. So once that's taken care of, that's really all she wrote for this one area. I mean, just a blueprint and everything. I don't know what purpose those bats serve, to be honest. Other than just being there, I guess. Now, as for goodies. Well, as we know from Jungle Japes before, most of the bananas do basically grow on tops of trees. Not on trees, the tops of trees. So, yeah, there's that, I guess. And over here will be a hunky chunky barrel. Which means I get to grow big and strong and big, and I can just walk, literally run over enemies. As you see, there is a banana barrel right there, but I'm gonna spend more time just collecting stuff. Because these trees are too big for just one simple monkey. You have to be big. You have to be strong. You have to be a giant. Now that I got that, I'll just simply backflip. And what do we have here? Minecart Mayhem. This one will require a little bit of know-how. Now, it starts off pretty easy. B is for break. Actually, A is for break. B is also for break, evidently. The trick is you don't want that thing to hit you. So you kind of want to just think on the fly with the TNT barrel, because it will follow you. So if you're on the wrong lane, yeah, it'll run into you. It'll basically use any junction it has at its arsenal to try to get to you. But as long as you're one step ahead and have an idea where the TNT barrel is going, you should be fine. That one is exceedingly simple, not only because of the 30 seconds, but because there's only one. It gets really tricky when they throw two TNT barrels at you. Where basically it's forcing your hand the whole time. And for about the first 20 seconds, you're playing damage control, pretty much. I don't think there's anything here for Chunky back in look. Instead, I believe there is... Wow, there's some stuff for Lanky right there. There's Chunky's golden banana. That'll require a timer. I think I know where a lot of Chunky's bananas are, actually. There's... Wow, I already got 60? Oh, I didn't realize that. Wow. I really didn't realize that. I know there's a good bit of Chunky's bananas right where Rambi was. That Rambi door. Take that detour, you get some goodies, because I believe there is a boulder there. Yeah, it makes sense, because there's a boulder there which has a switch. And 30... Wow. Wow. 30 bananas if you want them. Jeez. Oh, and that thing left 5 more. So Chunky's really is just all bunched together. This probably is the trickiest one of the timed bananas to get. Because Chunky moves so slow. And you don't have the aid of the banana port this time. Well, banana port 4 anyway. Banana port 2, on the other hand, you do. And you're definitely going to want to use that. Unless you think you can shortcut your way up Funky's armory, but... Really, don't think that's a smart move. It's a little chancy, and especially when you consider the fact that Chunky pretty much has a negative vertical leap. Yeah. But anyway, I should be able to make this just barely. 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, yeah. As I said, just barely. But we got it. And that's all she wrote for Jungle Japes, officially. Which means, now it's time for... well, Angry Aztec. And you know what? I think I can at least secure a bunch of stuff in that time frame. Maybe not everything, but most everything. Eh, you know what? I'll just have the part run over. I don't care. I don't care. It'd be stupid for me just to leave Chunky's Fire Bananas for here, because, well, as you know, I've gotten everything at this point. I don't care, Rankly! I got everything! Jeez. Rudely interrupted. What'd I tell you? No courtesy. No courtesy from the dead. Leave the dead lie, Forty. Leave the dead lie. That's probably like the one thing that I really... I mean, I try to be funny. But that's like the one thing I really, really, really... Whoops, wrong button. Am nervous about anything with the dead, because... I mean, unless it's somebody terrible, like, say, Hitler or Bin Laden or somebody like that, then you really don't feel as bad. But just, like, a random person. Even if it's a stupid death or whatever, where it was like, oh, the person who drunk drove and smashed a tree, still. I mean, you don't wish that evil on anybody. You don't really wish that people would just die like that. And just sort of making a joke about the dead just seems tactless, really. It's not something you do. Just don't think it's right. I mean, yeah, even with some of the Darwin Award type things, where a person did a really stupid thing and will pay the ultimate price. I'm not sure. It's just seems like really not the right thing to do. That's like the number one thing I shy away from whenever making jokes. And you think it'd be like some sort of hot button topic like race or whatever? No. That is probably more, that's probably the most filter thing I have. Well, that's not to say I don't care about other hot button topics and shit, but that's probably the one for me. Which just seems kind of weird, but yeah, it is what it is. Anyway, Chunky's got one more thing he can take care of here. And that'll give me my second golden banana in, well, pretty short order. The third one will be just up ahead where Tiny's cursed blat was. And once we open this door, we'll be on our way to our next golden banana. So what could possibly be through here? A golden banana! Oops. Did I say a golden banana? I meant a whole slew of enemies. And it's only claptraps. It's not really, you know, a giant threat or anything like that. I mean, seriously, this is pathetically easy. Especially since you can serve splash damage and all that. And there we go. That should be that. So, yep, that took me all of like 20 seconds. And that's number 68. So, let's leave. Shut up. I could care less what you think. See if there's any bananas down here. Answer? No. There isn't. No bananas here for Chunky. Oh well. Worth a try. I guess on to the next one. So Chunky's next goal in banana would be right up here. Right along here. Are you swiping at me or are you barking at me, Kremlin? I don't approve of either, but I can live with one. We have a hunky chunky barrel right here, and, well, if we step on that platform, we open up a cage, but that doesn't help. We need something that'll stay down. And like I said, you can just run over enemies when you're in hunky chunky form, which is kind of fun. You're basically invincible when you're in this form. Basically, I don't think even a Zinger or a grenade can actually affect you. That was cheap. Doesn't look like there was anything there for Chunky, so... whatever. I'll find something for him yet. Anyway. We will go through here, and there'll be a new challenge waiting. This one should be...
Busy
Barrel Barrage. Now, your basic thing here is survive the onslaught by using your blaster. The pineapple launcher can kill him in one hit, so... The tricky part is getting past the first wave, because you have four Kremlins come after you. Once you get past that, this is a joke. You can roll, just basically roll the stick and everything. But I really wouldn't consider it. You kind of want to direct your fire at a certain area and just keep going. You have infinite ammo. So, efficiency be damned. This is a real case of gun control, meaning hitting your target. And because they all respawn at the same rate, since you won't kill all the Kremlings at one time, you don't have to worry about facing more than one or two Kremlings at any given point in time. Which is a good thing.
Well done.
See? Once you get past that first onslaught, you're fine. And Chucky's already got number 3. So, where the rest of his bananas are. I only got 29, which is pretty low. So, where to look? Well, I can go to his five door, to his, temple door and secure some stuff there, but... ah. Prospects are looking up. Hey! I'm busy admiring the scenery. Jackass. Let's see. Maybe there's something in the Llama Temple? I don't know. There could be. There could be something in the Llama Temple, but... well, I won't be able to get in there directly with Chunky. I'll have to... sneak a way in. Anything in the Banana Port 5? Coins. Chunky could always use more coins. That was kind of a Debbie Downer, but I can live with that. Yeah, I'm just gonna take care of the business with that thing, and I'll just cut away to wherever I find bananas afterward. That'll probably be the best thing to do, and it'll at least save me some of the searching frustration. Chunky has the longest winded temple of the bunch. How long? instead of giving you 25 or 30 seconds, they give you 40 seconds to leave. And it ain't because you run slow. This is a big one. And his Chris Platt's actually in here too. Some really creepy music. I've never done that before. Okay, another balloon. Nice. Yeah, all the others are like really cool shockwaves and stuff. This is just perfect. Yeah. Okay, time to stop fooling around. Let's actually get this thing. Screw you. There we go. That took a little too long. One of these. Ah, yeah, here we are, Chris Platt. Leads to that switch, which is kind of unusual, because this opens up this area. And a bonus stage. Wow, that zinger is really tiny compared to that banana barrel.
Welcome to bonus stage!
Kremlin Kosh, we haven't seen this one yet. It's basically whack-a-mole. They're worth two, but they're also a lot harder to hit. There was sort of an implied speed with the melon, but if anything is in the lower half, you'll be more likely to hit that than if it was in the upper half of barrels. And I just took care of that really quick, which kind of shocked me. And now it's time to leave before the native gets angry. And with relative ease, I'm out. So anyway, I'm missing about 16 bananas, I want to say, for Chunky. 16 exactly. So, I'm gonna find 16 bananas. I'm just gonna cut to when I find them. Okay, there's six. There we are. What a sizable chunk on top of these. Anyway, that's Chunky's bonus, okay. So, yeah. Chunky's banana melon, so I think we're done here. Next time, we'll actually take on the next stage. With all the Kongs in tow, and caught up in everything. See you guys in 40 Warriors, signing off.